Hi guys, DC Breaks back in the lab with another video today all about a really interesting AI-powered tool called Voice-Swap. Now, I've looked at a lot of AI tools for making music over the last few months, and there's a huge amount of variability in terms of the quality, about the usability, whether they're actually using genuine AI technology such as machine learning, diffusion models, or neural networks. But a lot of them, in fact, pretty much all of them, have some serious question marks hanging over them around how ethical they are in terms of whether they're using data that they have the rights to use. So today we're going to be looking at Voice-Swap. And for me, this is one of those rare AI tools that not only produces super high quality audio, it also solves a very real world issue for music producers, and it's ethical in the way that it compensates the artists that it works with. So let's jump on in and take a look at Voice-Swap. So this is the Voice-Swap website. And as you can probably tell, this is where you can access the tool that allows you to transform your vocals to match those of somebody else. In this case, from one of a number of Voice-Swap's chart-topping singers or indeed session artists. Now, you've probably seen this type of effect online on any number of viral videos where someone has made a model, a voice model of someone famous like Joe Biden or a famous singer, and then created an amusing video or a song using that voice model. But obviously, in those cases, those individuals whose voice has been modeled hasn't given permission to that person to do it. So what Voice-Swap does for the first time is to create a legal system that allows you as a producer to legally use the voice of a different artist. And so there's a system on the website to get the approval, or the allow the artist to give approval to your demos, and then to also license that recording to you so that they can be compensated and also they can control the output, because otherwise I could create a song of them singing whatever I want and they may not agree with it from a moral, political or other point of view. So let's jump on and see how it works. You can create a free account. You can get 60 seconds of audio credits for free to try it out. There's also a really good Discord server with lots of conversation going on about how to use it effectively. But essentially, from your dashboard, you can choose one of the featured artists. You can find out more about them by clicking on the relevant tiles. And as I said, there's also a number now of session artists that has been added. So this list of artists is only going to grow. And one of the reasons for that is that this is a system that allows these artists to really take control of the intellectual property that they have around their obviously great singing voices. And otherwise it's a bit of a wild west, or it could be a wild west of people just using their voices without their permission, but this allows them to control it. It also allows them to monetize it. And we'll see how that works shortly. To use the service, you simply click upload. From the upload page, you can then drag and drop in your audio here or use a microphone, and you can choose your model from the dropdown. Now, I wouldn't necessarily recommend using the microphone option, because to get the best results out of this, you really need to do a bit of processing to your vocal first. So best practice means that you should really avoid any use of things like reverb or delay or any other kind of creative effects processing that's going to potentially confuse the model. You want your vocal to be clear and as clean as possible. So to that end, you might choose to compress the vocal, apply some EQ, generally clean it up as much as possible, but without applying any kind of wet effects like reverb, for example. Now, I'm not necessarily brave enough or stupid enough to put myself singing on the internet, because I'm a terrible singer. So what I'm going to be doing is using a suitable a cappella vocal stem from a track that I've worked on with another artist who's a very capable singer called Eva Lazarus, a fantastic singer. And so we're going to be transforming her voice, which already sounds great, but into Aymara, just for the point of demonstrating how well this technology works. So let's take a listen to Eva Lazarus. I've also chosen the track We Never Slow Down because it has a combination of singing and also more kind of spoken word rapping type of performance as well. And that will hopefully test the model to see how effective it is at kind of handling that kind of nuance in performance. So let's take a listen.
Rude girl with the sauce doing damage. Hot pepper body done your dance and make them panic. Me knowing I never got hook on a rhythm when I'm warning. Getting heavy with it, no, I'm never stalling.
Okay, so there are a few tips here as well. It's automatically detected the right key, which is B. So we're going to go ahead and process the audio and see how well we can get this to sound, in fact, not like Eve Lazarus, but Aymara. Now, when you do that, you do get a few warnings about having permission to do this, and also making sure that you're not posting anything on social media, and making sure that you own the copyright for any audio content, and so on and so forth. And also some tips on how to get assistance if things don't exactly go to plan. So once you've agreed to all of that, and again, this is a legally bound system that's designed to really take care of the artists themselves and to protect their intellectual property. It's very important that does that. And while I'm talking, this is running, and as you can see just how fast this is, it only takes about a minute or so to actually go ahead and perform the voice swapping operation. It says it can take up to 30 seconds, but depending on the length of the audio as well, it could be quicker than that, or perhaps a little bit longer too. Okay, let's have a listen and see how it sounds.
Rude gear, with the sauce doing damage. Hot pepper body down your dance and make them panic. Look out, gassy and moving on erratic. Shaking in their Nike and mats in their jackets.
So it's handled this part pretty well. I thought it might struggle perhaps with this, and it would be better suited to a kind of singing performance necessarily, more so than this type of performance. What I would say is if you listen carefully, you can hear a little kind of vibrato warbling type of effect where it's kind of maybe struggling to find the pitch. And so you can potentially go back and try some different pitch variations to see how that works. Or you could go back and process the original vocal slightly differently. There's quite a lot of sort of sliding, sort of gliding between notes that's going on, which might cause that. Let's see how it's handled the singing as well.
I'm hitting level, step up on my level. Them can't try me, no, and I never go hooking or in a winner warning.
So, I mean, it is really uncanny how well this works. Perhaps to get a more dramatic effect, let's try switching from a female to a vocal. So let's try listening and seeing how this sounds with Liam Bailey singing this instead. Okay, here's Liam Bailey singing We Never Slow Down.
Rude girl, with the sauce doing damage. Hot pepper body down your dance and make them panic. Look out, gassy and moving on erratic. Shaking in their Nike and mats in their jackets. Keep it stacking, they don't know what that is. A difficult, I'm hitting level, step up on my level. Them can't try me, no, and I never go hook on a riddle with a warning. Getting heavy with it, no, I'm never start.
I mean, it's just uncanny, isn't it? It's crazy. Let's go back and try pitching it down as well a little bit, see how it kind of handles that. Let's go for, say, 5 semitones.
Rude girl, with the sauce doing damage. Hot pepper body down your dance and make them panic. Look out, I'm gassy and moving on erratic. Shaking in their Nike and mats in their jackets. Keep it stacking, they don't know what that is. Level, step up on my level. Them can't try me, no, and I never go hook on a riddle with a warning.
So you can use the pitch control to more accurately fit the vocal range of the singer that they would be normally kind of used to singing in, and that could produce slightly better results as well. And then just for a final comparison, let's try picking the vocals of one of these session singers. Let's try Julia and see how she sounds singing the same song. In this case, we'll try perhaps pitching it up a little just to get a different flavor again. Okay, so this time we have Julia, one of the session singers, singing We Never Slow Down.
Rude girl, with the sauce doing damage. Hot pepper body down your dance and make them panic. Look out, I'm gassy and moving all erratic. Shaking in their Nike and Max in their jackets. Keep it stacking, they don't know what that is. A different cloth, another fabric, classic. I'm hitting level, step up on my level. Them can't try me, no, I never go hook on a riddle with a warning. Getting heavy with it, no, I'm never starting.
Yeah, so I think you can agree, again, all three of those models sound really, really realistic and ultimately are very usable. And that's one of the things that lets down a lot of AI tools, and that they don't produce high quality enough results to be practical in the real world. One limitation of it, I think, though, is that if you don't now save your audio, then you're at risk of kind of chewing through your credits. Because if I now navigate away and want to kind of come back and reprocess that same bit of vocal, that's going to eat up some of my available credits. I think it would be better if it only counted once you actually save it or download the audio. But that aside, let's look now at what happens next. Hey Hey guys, I hope you're enjoying the content. Just to let you know that we offer online courses in a range of creative subjects. So if you're interested in taking your skills and knowledge to the next level, check out the link below. So if you make a song and you're happy with it and you want to release it, you need to obtain a license, and you can do that through the license request tab on the website. So you just click on buy license for the relevant artist. The featured artists cost between $150 for 10 seconds up to $350, and you simply fill out this instant license request form and the artist will commit to giving you a response within 48 hours. So it's just things like your name, address, artist name, and so on, what type of release, where it's going to be released, and the demo itself. And then when you submit your request, it's up to the artist to then say yes or no. And I suppose they might say no because they don't like the song, or it doesn't sound right. It's not going to portray them in the right light, or the content's wrong, or potentially offensive, I guess. But if they say yes, you're then licensed to use that recording, that audio recording, in a song, in which case they're not going to be appearing as a feature artist. So if I did a full song and it was approved, I could then release that as DC Breaks, name of the track, but it wouldn't say featuring Liam Bailey, although he may appear within the credits. The alternative is that they say no, but actually they would like to feature, in which case you can then negotiate through the platform for that artist to be a feature artist on that particular record. That may then lead to a re-record to make sure that the vocal is perfect if there's a few little AI imperfections in there. And if that negotiation is successful, the Voice-Swap platform gets 20% of any deal that you strike. It's worth mentioning again that the session musicians are a bit cheaper again if you want to go down that route. They're still very high quality voice models, in which case the pricing is $50 for 10 seconds up to $100 for a full song. And this list of artists is only going to grow. It's already grown very rapidly in the short time this service has been around. And after all, there's a lot of reasons why vocalists would want to use this. Not only can they control the IP in their own voice, not only can they monetize and make money from licensing their voice, it may also lead to future sort of collaborations with artists that they wouldn't necessarily considered, but it's also a way of preserving their voice. You know, they can create a model for how their voice sounds at this moment in time. And of course, their voice will change as they get older. So there's that to it as well. And also, if you're already working with a team of producers, it allows that team of producers to work on demos without having to have you in the studio there recording all the time as well. So it might actually speed up and expedite the whole process of creating demos for those artists themselves as well. So that's Voice-Swap, a really great example of a powerful AI tool that's trying to do things the right way and working in an ethical framework. Let me know what you think about the video in the comments below. Don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button to get more videos like this delivered straight to your inbox from us here at the DBS Institute. But that's it for this video, and I'll see you in the next one.